Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So today I'm going to show you guys how to keep your aquariums clean with a simple and easy to do project that you already have the supplies to do. Now typically speaking, we keep our aquariums clean and free of debris during our regular aquarium maintenance routines. Most people do what they need to do to keep their aquariums clean during a water change, which for the most part is usually about once a week. But what about in between those times? Everybody wants to keep their aquariums healthy, but a lot of us want to keep our aquariums looking great all of the time as well. So I'm going to show you how to do just that. The do-it-yourself aquarium gravel vacuum. We all know what a gravel vacuum is. We usually do it when we're doing our water changes once a week. However, breaking out all that water change equipment, if you have a lot, can be a bit tedious at times, especially if it's not the time of the week to do your water change. Sometimes we just want to remove a little bit of the debris that is accumulated on top of or within your gravel without actually having to remove any water. And that's exactly what my gravel vacuum does. So, let's get started. So the first thing that you're going to need is an aquarium air pump. Now, this is actually something that a lot of people already have in this hobby. Whether you have one and you stopped using it, a lot of people either have one existing on an aquarium or at least one kicking around. If not, they're pretty cheap and you can find them almost anywhere for a fair price. You're going to need some air line and an air stone. You'll also need a water bottle, a very simple water bottle. 500 milliliters is the preferred size, or at least something slim. You're also going to need an elastic of any type, doesn't matter, and a fine mesh bag. You have a few options here. You can buy mesh bags. You can also use a filter sock, you could use old pantyhose, you could use old media bags, just cut them open, empty the media out, and then you have a fine mesh bag as well. And that's it. So to begin, we're going to start off with the actual water bottle. What you're going to want to do is cut the bottom off first, leaving the top intact, and remove the cap because you're not going to need it. So we now have a bottomless water bottle. Next thing you're going to want to do is make a small hole in the water bottle, just small enough to be able to insert your airline. Now the size of the hole in the bottle only needs to be big enough to be able to pass the airline actually through it, with your airstone on the end. The distance of the bottle from the airline is about 1 inch to a half inch from the bottom, and it's just going to sit just like that. We're almost done now. Next up, your mesh bag. We're going to take that mesh bag, as well as your elastic, and we are going to take it and tie it to the top of the bottle, right around the neck of the bottle. That's it. Then plug it into your actual airstone, your air pump. Now I'm going to show you how it works and why it works. So the first thing you're going to want to do is turn your actual air pump on. Obviously, bubbles will start to rise out of the airstone after you do so. What's going to happen is those bubbles are going to create suction behind them and suck water up through the bottle and through the mesh bag. However, in doing so, it's also going to suck up any debris that's accumulated underneath the bottle as you're going along your tank. You can do this with gravel, sand, or even a bare bottom aquarium. As that debris travels up the bottle and out the neck, it gets trapped in this bag. However, you don't remove any water in doing so. So that's the great part about it. Another thing that I like about this is very simple. What I do, personally, is I have my normal air pump running continuously on my aquarium. I have its own air stone and its own air line for that. As for my gravel vacuum, I have my own air line and air stone for that as well. Both kept separate. So now all I need to do is actually unplug the air pump from the aquarium, plug it into my gravel vac, and I can use it, and then put it back on the aquarium. Very simple. So now the total cost of this was next to nothing for me. I already had an air pump, you might as well, but if you don't, maybe $10-$15. It'll go a long ways though. You can use it on your existing aquarium and take it off when you want to do your gravel vacuuming. You'll also have the spare pop bottle or water bottles available as well. A mesh bag, like I said, there's a lot of alternatives. Again, I didn't pay anything for it as I had one kicking around the house. And an elastic. Everybody has elastic. Airline tubing is usually about 10 cents a foot. I'm using about 3 feet here. So 30 cents, 25 cents for an airstone. So I mean under a dollar for all of this. Under $2 for sure. So that's it, folks. That's how you can keep your aquarium clean in between your regular maintenance routine. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you find something useful out of it. I definitely want to thank you for watching, and we'll see you.